it has a history that goes back 1500 years, and I think it's a fantastic place. There's also a feeling of calmness and serenity. The Garden of Wales, they call it. I think it's a certain amount of wonderment, mystery. The mysteries of why we have a town hall. Llantrit Major was never a town. Who was Illtud? Why did he establish a monastery here? Was there, as they think, a royal family nearby? It's a curious mix.
The Blue Plaque Trail was suggested as a tourist attraction, really. We've got a lot of really old buildings with a lot of history. And I find if I walk around the town in the summer particularly, that there are people, strangers, asking what's that and what's its history. Well, if they've got something to read, something to see what it is, you see them stopping and looking and reading things. And I think it's great.
The Blue Plaque Trail will give people an idea of how things change over time.
The town hall is attributed to Gilbert de Clare in the 1200s. The building itself had many uses. It was used very much as a marketplace and later on as a guild hall. It's a Victorian clock given to Llantrit, and for some years it didn't strike, and now it's striking again, which is great.
Bethesda Row is very much an independent chapel, established in 1807. Which now nestles in between the RAF St Athens hangars. It still is without electricity and without water. Music is provided by a harmonium which has to be pedalled. We reckon that one church service used to equal one section of the Tour de France. The Old Swan is a 16th century building frequented by William Randolph Hearst and, of course, all the film stars outraging the locals because the lady stars and starlets would be wearing trousers.
A lot of the old biddies in Llantrit thought it was scandalous that he came there with one of his mistresses, and the square must have been a riot of public houses.
Boverton Place, a 16th century pile built by the Says family, is now in ruin because the last of the Says had married Robert Jones of Fonmon Castle.
Down towards the beach is Ham Lodge. And this is really all that remains of the Ham, which was a very grand house, perhaps the grandest in Llantrit.
It's very Gothic. You can almost see the Adams family living there. The Ham was destroyed by fire in 1947, allegedly by American soldiers being a little less than careful with matches and cigarettes. Noel's Place, we always call it the old school. We can date it actually to 1456. And it was built for the Raglan family, who were part of the Herbert family, the Earls of Pembroke, who were very much an important family. The Gatehouse is the entrance to the monastic grange established by the monks of Tewksbury Abbey.
I suppose carriages came through it, and there was somebody living in it, I presume.
Very fine building which survived until 1836, until it was dismantled.
Plymouth House is a lovely looking building, very, very elegant. Lovely windows and it has a real presence in this part of Lantwick.
It was originally the manor house of West Llantwit. The present owner claims that it was built in 1485. Plymouth House is named after the Earls of Plymouth, who lived in St Fagans.
It's got a mounting block outside which visitors see as they come up to the house. This was because everyone, or many people, rode horses. And as I can tell you as a rider, as you get older, you need something to go up to get you up there.
The old place is sometimes known as Llantwit Castle. It's not a castle, never has been. It was probably built in the 1590s for the Van family, much to the annoyance of the people in the area who thought that the Vans were upstarts. They're the family who became involved in the Great Affray of 1597. The Vans and the Says families, the Says of Boverton Place, didn't exactly see eye to eye. So in fact, the Vans took cudgels and swords to church and actually wore them in church. Now this was really not a good idea. After church, they attacked the Says, and the Says took refuge probably in the town hall, and there are even stories of swords being put through doors.
In fact, it was such a nasty do, and such a they didn't have, I suppose, in those days, so they went to the Star Chamber, and the whole thing went to the Star Chamber as a court case.
And the Vans, the two of them, were fined the equivalent of about £1.5 each.
They really went bankrupt, and it was then that they moved out and the place was left in ruins. The Old White Hart was a townhouse. This is one of the oldest houses in the area. It's attributed to the 1400s and was built after the Glyndwr revolts, which did a lot of destruction, they think. This is another building with a mounting block outside. There must have been quite a lot of horses about everywhere. That one was obviously quite well used, with people coming out of the pub and needing to get on their horses, perhaps a bit unsteadily.